this is not a typical bingo night. Seven Hills Foundation runs the largest bingo game in central Massachusetts. This thrice-weekly bingo night brings the Worcester nonprofit hundreds of thousands of dollars a year in donations. Seven Hills needs the money to continue providing health and human services to people in the community. At a time when nonprofits are anticipating at least a 20% decrease in giving, bingo night is the only reliable income Seven Hills can depend on.
Well, obviously we wouldn't be doing it if it wasn't financially successful. We're raising about $500,000 net per year, which is an enormous amount of money. And in this economy, it's not easy to raise $500,000.
Seven Hills is just one of the many nonprofits being forced to get creative with fundraising. The new trend, giving without giving. The idea is for nonprofits to align themselves with what people already spend on. In this case, bingo.
The interesting question, do they come to support Seven Hills or do they come to win money? I think it's the latter.
Bingo regular Brenda Bowanke won't give up bingo, but can't afford to donate regularly to charities. So Seven Hills is a perfect match for her.
People go out in the bar and blow their money and nobody benefits from it. At least when you go to bingo, there are people that benefit from it.
And the internet makes it even easier for nonprofits to receive donations through unconventional practices. Medicines for Humanity has turned to this website, iGive.com. The nonprofit provides simple medicines to people in third world countries and hopes iGive can help make up some of the money they've lost.
In view of the economy, what's happening in the economy, it's particularly critical now that nonprofits scratch and claw and look for ways to raise money that we haven't relied on before. We came across a group called iGive that has set up a way to enable people to give without giving, in effect.
When people use iGive, as much as 15% of whatever they spend online goes to the charity of their choice. Donors don't have to spend anything extra for their cause. So far, iGive has been successful. Medicines for Humanity has raised $36 in just 1 month from a select number of test users. But Bilodeau is weary about this type of giving.
I don't think it will supplant the traditional ways of fundraising, which for us and for many nonprofits include reaching out to individuals and to organizations and to foundations.
It may not be traditional, but bingo is bringing in the bucks. An average player at Seven Hills spends $27 three times a week, and with 300 plus players a night, it's no wonder why revenue from bingo keeps Seven Hills afloat.
Bingo is enormous because, if all else fails, we have $500,000 net to begin with.
It may not be as easy as stamping a bingo sheet, but nonprofits like Seven Hills and Medicines for Humanity are hopeful these new methods of fundraising will carry them through this financial meltdown. I'm Cassidy Quinn.